Where am I? Echo, we're finally to all over. We're finally to be together forever and ever. It's you.
There's no door in here. What the hell?
We're finally together, Echo. There's no escape now. I'll save you, Echo.
Konata? Where do you come from?
I know a secret exit from here, because I am just that awesome. I can go through the floor. Let's go, Echo.
Whoa.
You think you can get away that easily? I can do that too. I'll get you someday, Echo.
Welcome back to Let's Play. Hatsune Miku Project Diva F. Again, laptop a little closer. So that was a pretty random clip there. Another reference to Echo the Dolphin and Yandere-chan. It's just... like, I've got ideas for kind of reoccurring kind of characters from Let's Plays for this LP, like different type of scenarios you could put them in. And Yandere-chan and Echo, obviously, two of those type of characters. And that room literally doesn't have a door. I remember the first time I came across that and I was just looking around through it and I was just like, there's no door to this room! And it's kind of funny that I had the photo of the dolphins in there as well. It's just like, oh, this will be very fitting for that type of scene. And since, you know, you can like adjust the height and all that of where they're standing, I was like, they could technically go under the floor, so have that as their means of escape, have Kohantar come in and save him. It's just like, that's a random idea. And yeah. Also, I've gotta say, Rin looked, well, Maya, I guess, the crazy Yandere from Yandere-chan, looked pretty damn intimidating. It was like, between my voice acting, the music and the facial expression, just like, damn, that fits quite well. If you've not seen my Yandere-chan LP on my VN, Blue Skull Dragon VN channel, it's really just like, in terms of voice acting, it's probably one of my better kind of ones, because like, it's like a scene where it gets incredibly intense and I'm just like voice acting. Echo is just like, no, you damn it, this is what it's supposed to be, blah, blah, blah. He's just like, it was you. And she's just like, shut up, you fool. You think I'd fall for that? Just like, really just back and forth commentary on that between the two characters. It was really quite intense. But anyways, also, I just, like, today realized that you can actually move the character right here. You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a record, baby, right round, play the game. Okay. Was there something else I was going to say? Ah, yes, now I remember. You remember that drawing that I did a while back? I finally completed it, and no wonder why I've been exhausted lately. It's not the drawing part of it. I'd completed that, so like, back when I, you know, showed that image, but it's the coloring in part that's really time consuming, because, you know, if you're like using, well, even if I use kind of picture editing software to kind of color it in, I still find that time consuming, because I want to get every detail, but I was just like, it's just got pencils, and I didn't even have a sharpener for quite some time as well, so it's just like, if the pencil is just like unable to be used, they're just like, ah, shit. Just like, eh. So it took ages to get all the color in, and I was just exhausted after that, but here it is. It turned out alright, and in fact, I've actually used it in this game itself, you know, for taking screenshots. Which will probably be shown at some point as well, but whatever. Also, I've got the fan on today, so maybe it won't fail as badly as last time. Because that was some serious bullshit. Well, to be fair, it was only the first one, wasn't it? After that, it kind of just like, It was a slow uphill slope. And then got perfect at the end, you know? Let's see... How about... Seriously, what the fuck is that? Wait. It's a bit in the odd kind of thing, but I think I've already made exceptions with some of them, so screw it, why not have some butterfly wings? Color somewhat matches-ish. Now I've gotta actually focus here, because this is gonna be quite a fast one. Butterflies! Yes, let's begin.
So, it's been a while since we've done any of this. Can barely hear the audio, really shouldn't use, you know, like, headphones, earphones, whatever, just so I can actually hear the music a bit better, because otherwise this picks up and it kind of gets awkward on the playback, because you gotta edit it in and it just has like a kind of, maybe an echo to it. Let me see if I can do something with that here, let's see. Yeah, maybe that. So, is Miku trying to seduce us again? It won't work, man, it won't work. If you got some leaks, then it'll either, well, I don't know, that would just piss me off, actually. You don't disrespect leaks in such a way. Bloody hell, my voice is echoing in this room today. Don't know if it's very noticeable on the actual recording, though. Ooh, yeah, awful loot. Dancing with musical instruments for the, I think maybe the third time. And not even the last time. The moon is in the air and fan service and all of that. I don't know if that went along with the music at all there, because I can barely hear the damn thing. Well, it is real. How come I didn't notice it the previous times, but did I? All the musical instruments just exploding? That'd be totally weird. Shit! I haven't got insurance on all this shit! Ah, oh, fuck it. It isn't actually mine anyway, it's somebody else's house. Well, mansion, whatever the hell. Well, at least the land's some fresh air. Just like this freaking building sucks! It's too damn warm! Now, only one awful note. Okay, so... 386. Well, at least it was only two instead of, you know, the usual five or more, because that gets pretty annoying. Do proceed, then.
Damn it, it's the same as last time. It's because I slowed down temporarily. That's the problem, you gotta keep it at, maintain that speed, the correct... Just keep with the rhythm. But I screwed it up. It's always the one, though. It's always this one, it's never too well. Sadly, there was a two in the previous one, but you get the idea, it's usually just a one. Let's see, it was something I was going to do. Ah, yes, the stylish one. Any stylish glasses? Of stylish move. I think we'll just go with the, just the modules, because these are modules that aren't actually used specifically for any song, so, you know, just use them. It goes with the color, though, doesn't it? I wonder if they'll camouflage. God damn it, I always do that. I always go up here instead of just going like this, because I keep thinking that is Mega Survival. Still not used to the combo safeguard, which is weird because I used it, like, all the time back in the day. Let us begin.
You know, what is stylish about a Band-Aid on the nose anyway? It's kind of odd, really, when you look at fashion in general, really. I mean, like, ripped jeans, it's just like, they actually sell jeans with rips in it. I mean, you could do that your bloody self! Quite silly when you really think about it. And Wonderworld would be kind of a weird example, like, someone just, like, randomly just put something on and it just like looks odd, but because it's so different, people are just like, yeah, that's very fashionable, man, let's do that. Now that would be weird when you really think about it. Imagine if Band-Aids like on the nose was actually fashionable and someone happened to just like, you know, bust up the nose a bit and then like not to a point where they'd like, you know, well, they essentially only just need to put like a little Band-Aid on it, because it's just like, ah, oh, my nose, and so it's like, hey, you're a very fashionable person. What? I just got banged on my nose. It's like, very fashionable, man. No, serious, that's what happened. Maybe that's what happened to them as well. It's not like they're trying to like be fashionable. They got the Band-Aids on because they slapped each other across the nose with the remote controller there. They're like, no, it's my remote controller, whack! Imagine having a remote controller that just makes people dance and act silly in general. You know, wouldn't be surprised if there is such a thing. Well, if it's not a thing, it's an enemy. I mean, with some people, it's easy to make them just do something completely silly. Usually money. Yeah, that's what it is, yeah. It's like, okay, here's some money, do this stupid thing, just like, how much money are we talking to? And then, like, depending on the price, you'll be like, I'll do it, man, money! It's like, you made an absolute fool of yourself. Yeah, but at least I got money for it. Holy shit. Holy crap, he hasn't had any bad notes. Oh my god. And it's over 500 of that. Surely he must have screwed up at some point. No! Bitch. Why must... Well... It's... Two times now this has happened on this song. Seriously, bullshit. 396. Well, at least someone having an extreme mode, but still. Fuck you. Get on with it. Seriously.
Wow, that was pretty intense. Surprised I got perfect. I could feel my rhythm getting thrown off here and there. I'm usually really good at this one. I mean, sure, I did get the perfect in the end, but still. Because, like, if I had done really well, I probably would have beat my previous high score, like I've done quite a few times. A bit rusty, I suppose. It's like, the faster it started to get, it's like, whoa, how do I do this? It's just like, oh shit, the switching bit, the arrow ones, and then like, where it's like, left, right, and then it switches over, right, left kind of thing. It's just like, oh, confusing. But I managed to pull through. You know, I'm surprised I haven't got perfect on this one. Well, actually, there's probably a good reason for that, and it's probably fine that much.
We're going with the scientist genius.
Let's see, anything for... Or just add something a little extra violence. Kato is the mad scientist who has created puppets of all the vocaloids. That is what's going down in the video that is to come. Well, not really, but that's how it'll look, wouldn't it? Let us begin.
Replicator returns. That's a huge ass gear right there. We in limbo. Not limbo as in, like, you know, actual limbo, I mean the game, because they had a lot of gears in that game. Those are giant gears of death, of course. That graveyard? Wait, actually, that could really kind of put it all together there a bit. Kind of fitting. Is that the sky in the background, or is it like a hole in the ceiling, or what, or is it quite a confusing location? Whoa! Okay, seriously, how does he keep doing that? Find it quite annoying, see, that he's not screwing up quite as much as he usually does. Where'd he get the crystals from anyway? I mean, what purpose does it serve? Does it power the puppets, or did he just think, you know, it kind of looks nice, so I decided to decorate the place a bit, you see? He'll definitely screw this one up. There's no way you can get it a second game. Balls, it didn't last long enough. Can you imagine living in a castle? You know, when you look at a castle, you're just like, oh my god, not a castle with those creepy dolls, though. Oh my god, screw haunted places. I mean, imagine if it was like... It wasn't haunted necessarily, but you had like these mechanical dolls all over the place. Actually, wasn't there a game somewhat recently that's like got quite a few sequels to it? I can't remember what it's called. But it's like some auto-mechanical kind of some restaurant, some security guard or something like that. I mean, I haven't played it, but my god, does it look terrifying. No! Bubbles. Where did I even come from anyway? Well, sky obviously, but where is the sky? Is someone dropping them from a helicopter or what? 406 leaks stolen from my vault, my collection, that I stole off Miku originally, but they're still mine. So fuck you. I'll get them back. Somehow. Come on! How many times do you have to do this? Get on with it. Get on with it! Damn pauses! You're taking the piss now, man. Get on with it.
Woo! I'm surprised. Like, when I saw the arrow notes appear, that's where I was like, yep, now I remember why I never got perfect on it. But I still got past them. And I also realized something that's incredibly obvious, but that I always have trouble with is, when there are a lot of notes coming together with like do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, it's not that it's increasing in speed or decreasing, you keep the same speed, that's the rhythm of it. You find it, and once, if it works, just press it the same speed. If you go faster or slower, you're bound to screw up on that. Obviously isn't the case with some actually do slow down or speed up partway through, but not in this case. So, I was a bit surprised to get perfect on that. I was surprised that I didn't get perfect on it, and now I'm surprised that I did. But that's after, you know, seeing the arrow notes, because they really screw you over. Because, like, it's like circle, circle, and then you've got a hold down circle and then right. It's just like, that's how you use the arrow keys. Because you gotta hit both buttons at the same time, so when you switch like that, it's not incredibly fast, but you get the idea, it can be quite confusing. What should we use for this one? Let's see. Sounded a bit like a robot there. How about this? Let's have a look, see. Not really much in variety, is there? But you're going to the cinema with a cowlick. So that should be interesting. And you shall wear some glasses, why not? That be all, yes. It makes you wonder, because, like, the place she goes to doesn't look like a cinema, but then when you open it up, it is. I mean, imagine if, like, some historical castle got a makeover. It's just like, okay, we're gonna turn it into a cinema. And now that I think about it, that's probably happened, and I just don't know about it. Well, the castles I've been to haven't had a cinema, but who knows, somewhere there might be a castle that has its own cinema. And it, well, actually, technically they do, in a way. They have, like, a kind of projector kind of thing. I remember that in one of them. It just, like, but it wasn't like, oh, let's watch movies on the big screen at the castle or anything. It was more of, let us, like, view this kind of video of the drawbridge, because it's not there anymore. So it'll show how it was, like, shown, like, how it'd be used back then and things like that and blah-de-blah-blah-blah. Let us begin.
You know, I just looked up the lyrics to this song, and you know what I've got to say? Damn, that's a lot of lyrics. I didn't even realize it. It's pretty much an entire story told in a song. I mean, sure, songs tell stories and all that, but it's like legitimately just full-on telling the story. So, I'm not entirely sure what the meaning behind the song actually is by looking at it, but I think they maybe, kind of a repressed people, kind of living where there is no sun and only kind of like leaks of rain, you know, and stuff like that. So they want to kind of, you know, find something, I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. By the way, there it goes, it's just like, you know, fuck this shit, we're getting out of here. There's a better world out there, I just knew it and all that jazz, you know? Not sure what that bit's all about. I don't know. You know, if it's always raining, then... Wait, I'm not sure if it actually... Yeah, I really need to, you know... not to look up the lyrics while, like, the recording is going on, because it doesn't really give me time to kind of take in the lyrics and kind of try to understand what it's actually about. But seriously, I didn't realize that so much lyrics. Tell you what, man, it puts a lot of songwriters to shame, doesn't it? Just like, oh, this just have the same thing looped over and over again throughout the song. Just like, yeah, 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 oh, yeah. He's like, screw that, I've got to tell an entire freaking story in like 3 or 4 minutes or something. It did mention something about this part of the song, I imagine, because it shows all the flowers and all that. Just like, wow, it's so beautiful. Not sure what, yeah, it actually, yeah, there's totally a lot more to the song. I mean, like right at the end and all that, which is just like waiting outside, and it's like, I don't know. It's definitely a story. I wonder if that's what the song was actually for, like, made the song and the video together to kind of blend together. Or, well, the video came after, he's just like, yeah, let's try to tell the story through that, you know? But there is something about an umbrella of some sort, but I'm not sure what it actually represents. Because, I don't know. Didn't have much time to look over the lyrics, you know? Well, actually, I have plenty of time, because he talks forever, man. Oh, come on! Why does this always happen? Perfect taste. 416. Is that like 3 perfects in a row? What kind of nonsense is this? Give me leaks or just... Oh, I can't even me far to insult you today. Huh. But, you know, do get on, Bree. I mean, there's a lot of pause and delay between the coming back to the main commentary, so, you know, get on with that. But seriously, it takes forever. Come on, man. Get on with it.
Three perfects in a row. Yeah. Certainly turned this around, haven't I? Bruce Potter's like, oh god, I failed so badly on that song. And then, like, kind of slowly turned it around, and now it's like three perfects in a row, man. I wonder if this one will, well, unlikely, this is one that I usually fail at. I know that much. Also, I keep forgetting to mention, like, some of the images that I've used as of late had like Sims 2 kind of background, and I haven't really commented on it, have I? It's like I just wanted more images to kind of use for the Vocaloids to take screenshots, and just like, how about looking through like the screenshots from the Sims 2, and I'm just like, okay, let's choose a few of these. A few random ones here and there, you know? Pretty random. For this one, can't really say quite a few of them, because only like a slight few that I've decided on what module to use before actually getting to the point. Let's see, though. Now that just look out of place, really, wouldn't it? Let's see. Nope. Well. Nah. Just that. That's extreme mode randomness. That is. And as I've said before, we can't have that until extreme mode. So, let's have a look see here. Now that doesn't really suit it, really, does it? Can you imagine, like, putting on a concert for aliens wearing a monocle? Well, can you imagine putting on a concert for aliens in general? Wait. Could it? No, it still looks out of place. Anything for the back? Let's have a look. Yeah, jetpack. May seem extreme, but it's not. So, it's acceptable. I mean, she's putting on a concert for aliens. Why wouldn't she have a jetpack? Gotta have something like that. Let us begin! Also, background R. Whatever. Let's go.
See, Miku's on a plane there? But anyways, So I kinda looked over the lyrics briefly for, like keyword briefly, because I didn't actually understand the song at all, because I was looking over it briefly, you know? Plus, the website that had the lyrics was pretty slow, so it's just like, screw it. But essentially, from what I could read of it, it has nothing to do with aliens or anything like that, so I don't really get it at all. I just kind of assumed she was, like, putting on a pop concert for aliens, but didn't know the lyrics, and again, it has that kind of story-like feel to it. Completely different to what you'd expect from, say, Western pop music, that's for sure. Just like, I mentioned, it's just like, oh yeah, ooh, I love you, yeah, let's make love and all that shit. And then you get all kinds of songs, really. Songs that kind of tell a story, like, literally told in a story kind of way, or is just like, songs that have a kind of meaning to it, but no real story. It's just kind of, it just sounds good all put together, you know? seriously, with some of these Vocaloid songs, you might as well write a book. I mean, there's so much lyrics. Plus, the weird thing with, like, translating from, oh, there's those aliens again, from, like, Japanese to English is, like, you'll notice, like, sometimes when it gets translated, it has a bit of a kind of English feel to it. You're just like, what the hell? Holy shit! Kill it! Had to go and eat, spam that button just to get through it, didn't you? Well, who wouldn't really? I mean, that's a real pain in the ass part right there. I don't know what this song's about, but it's got nothing to do with aliens and stuff. It said something about, I can't even remember, actually. But I don't remember it mentioning anything about an alien concert in... Ah! God damn it! Oh! You annoying bitches. You know, it really hasn't quite sunk in that you've just got four fucking puppets in a row! God damn it, that means... 426 leaps. Fucking god damn it. Oh, that, this is just, this, it, just, no words. Four perfect, hard mode, in a row. Bullshit, I'm out of here. I'll see you next time, and hopefully get some better leaks next time. So
get some well, how about that? I got a perfect despite that. I know that I would not have been able to get perfect without the combo safeguard, and I also know that if I had actually attempted the second technical zone properly, instead of just going biffy biffy spamming the analog stick like you're able to do, I probably would not have freaking fared well with that bit of rhythm there, because it looked confusing and looked like it'd be very easy to screw up if I wasn't just going biffy 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 with the analog. So that's 10, I think, so let's roll the dice. Which Vocaloid today? It is... I think that'd be Len, because it's free. The question is... What would Len actually want? I'm going to actually look it up here. Let's see what it looks like. Come on. I ain't got all day. Okay, that took a while. I was just looking through the, not just the objects and what they like and dislike, but also how they interact. There's actually a bit more to it than I thought. Like, I thought you can only, like, irritate them if you continuously pat them on the head for too long and you're just like, stop that. But apparently there are other ways to irritate them without doing that. So, noted. Just like Len's gonna be like, oh damn it, you're gonna try to irritate me, aren't you? Just to see if it works. But he likes stuffed bear, apparently. So we'll go with the stuffed bear. But yeah, it is the case with the Vocaloids. You just like pat them on the head until they close their eye when it reopens. Then you let go and they're like, yay, do that three times usually, and they challenge you with rock, paper, scissors. Hello, and switcheroo.
You're gonna be a big-ass plant someday. Then you'll take me to the clouds and I'll just be looking down on people and pee on them.
Hello, I have gifts and possible, trolling, I suppose. I do apologize, Len, but, I want to test these things out here.
Oh, arigato!
Okay, Len, let's have a look-see. So, it doesn't affect their mood, so that's good. We can look to the side, be on a certain distance. How do I do that? It's not doing anything. Wait. Ah, yeah, you gotta do that. Where, what distance though? I have no idea. Make them look to the side for a while. Doesn't seem to be doing anything. Any other ways? It looks like it's going to explode into his face. What the hell is going on with his hand? He doesn't seem to be irritated. Well, they can apparently fall asleep, so let's see that. That'd be interesting if it's just, but you're so boring I fell asleep. So I proceed to fall asleep while I just look over the various ways I can try to irritate you and fail. Looks like he's getting drowsy. There we go. He hasn't got the Z's above his head, though. Okay, now he has. Wakey wakey, Len, it's time to try to irritate you some more. Come on, it's gonna work, damn it, it's gonna work! We have to do it in a circular kind of way so he gets dizzy. Thank you.
I want to see the irritated face! Come on! God damn, the analog stick is a pain in the ass to do this with, you know. Does nothing irritate you? And if someone did this with their hand in my face, I'd get irritated at some point, you know. Len, you're screwing with my title plan for this part. It was gonna have it to do with the perfect, but now it's gonna be to do with trying to irritate Len and failing, probably. Len, goddammit! He must be listening to some music and he's just completely distracted. I'm gonna break the analog stick of this for it, Len!
It says making the vocaloid look to the side beyond a certain distance for some time.
What is this certain distance?
And how much time has to pass?
Just like, oh, about 4 hours. I mean, that's bound to irritate anyone, isn't it?
Well, he'd probably have fallen asleep. I mean, come on.
Only the analog stick seems...
Unless there's some secret control that I never knew.
Nope, doesn't seem to be.
No, that's for that dude. Yes.
He's not getting irritated, but I am. Maybe if I just continuously do this, maybe you'll get annoyed. Right? Right?
Paper scissors yet.
My hand is going to explode on your head. That made no sense. It's not working. He's just impossible to irritate.
Well, not impossible, but I don't want to irritate them the old-fashioned way, you know?
But to be original! By making his eyes feel like they're just about to pop out. Rather than actually poking him in the eyes. Come on, there's got to be some way. Somehow. Maybe if you just go, just like... Look up. Down.
And over here, and up, and across.
This is your eye test, Len. Can you see this hand? Can you see this hand here? Can you see I'm giving you the middle finger? Well, it's not my middle finger, but it might as well be. And up here, and down here, and across here, and up here. There's your thing, and there's a poster. And, oh, he's getting irritated. It's working, it's working. So you go up here, yes, it's, and then we go down here, there's your bed with futon, really, and then you go up here, and across here, there we go, irritated face. Just like, oh, my eyes. Okay, now that we finally succeeded after God knows how long. Now he's probably gonna kick my ass at this game. He always does. Bloody hell, 53 minutes? Well, it's a bit longer than that with the intro and all that, but holy shit, this part went on so much longer because of this. Alright then, it's go time. Damn it. I told you, man. Damn it! I should know that strategy never works with you. Next time I get it, I'm not gonna choose that direction. I know he'll choose that direction, because that's what always happens. Okay, maybe not. I was right. Well, I was right and wrong at the same time. Shit! You son of a... Whatever you're a son of. I just thought of an odd joke here. Those extra vocaloids aren't like proper vocaloids, you know, right? And vocaloids are technically synthesizers, so I'm just imagining someone just like being like, you're not a real vocaloid, your father was a freaking keyboard. Just like, oh! What? I don't know, my mind thinks of random shit. This is gonna take a while. Man, Len, you're not having a curb-stomping day like you usually do. I mean, usually he curb-stomps me, but apparently not up to this time. Yeah! Damn it. The middle fingers. Man, you're just not getting the guessing right. But so am I, very much. We're both failing. But surprisingly, I'm winning. Sort of. Could go either way. This is the most intense battle so far, man.
Damn it, of course. I guess this is payback in a way then, I suppose. It's like, you irritated me, I'm gonna irritate you. This is going to be the longest game of rock, paper, scissors you've ever had in your entire life. It seems we tie. Damn it! Just gonna make a bit of a rhyme there and just be like, but that's a lie, because I won. But no, it didn't happen. Yay! He sounded a bit like Rin there for a second when he's with the high-pitched voice, which seems fitting, really, since, you know, they're siblings and all. Well, Rin, it was... Well, Len, got you mixed up there. It was nice irritating you and somewhat being irritated by you as well. That was an intense battle of rock, paper, scissors. Most intense rock, paper, scissors I've ever had in my entire life. This part is going to be an hour long by looks of things. And that's quite ridiculous. I mean, it didn't seem like it was going to be that long with the actual gameplay, but since we got to the vocalized room, it's just like, oh no. Victory dance, is just like, wait, I lost the rock, paper, scissors, but who cares? Victory dance! So anyway, the clip to conclude this part is a reference to Emit, which is a kind of visual novel that I LP'd on my other channel, so... Well, I pretty much just like, I didn't know how to reference it, so I literally just like recorded the audio for part of the LP itself, just a random clip from it, and just like put it in, because why not? And I had to kind of improvise, use my imagination a bit, because in the scene she puts down a coin paying for the tea, you see, and that kind of rhymed, and essentially they don't have coins. You can't actually have the vocaloids hold the coins or anything, so I kind of improvised and pretty much used a bass guitar pick, so that's pretty random. Well, anyways, I'll see you next time, viewers. On with that. See you next time.
No world, a person like you is actually old and respected. How weird. Me, old and respected? How ridiculous. Don't be silly. I've had enough. She was all right with it until you called her old. This is fatigue. She's like, excuse me? I don't like to be called old around here. Or anywhere for that.